Hi there. In this video I'm going to add Bluetooth capability to this amplifier and a speaker port and change the cable, but most important, adding this capability Bluetooth. Also, something that I will need to show you how to do is transform the stereo output of this thing into mono signal for this thing, because this is a mono amplifier. So let's get through this. Let me tell you the things and show you what I need and want to do. First, I need to change this because it's UK style. And I'm in Romania, so I need to put another one. Yeah, this is an old one, dirty one. I will clean it, obviously. Next thing, this is a combined, line amplifier and standard speaker amplifier, as you can see. Focus. It can handle 4 ohm and then 82 ohm at 70 volts, 167 ohm at 100 volts, and it does not have a simple standard speaker connector on it. It has this weird green thing. Probably it had an adapter to split it, whatever. I don't have that. So I'm going to put this simple speaker connector somewhere. I need to find a place where it will not affect anything, not bother anything. Probably here I will drill holes and put it in this area right here, probably like this actually. Okay, so next. This thing has three inputs. One is for microphone with phantom power and without phantom power. And this one is actually tied to the input on the front for microphone. So this one I will leave for microphone. This one is for mic and auxiliary. This is what I'm going to use to connect my Bluetooth module. And this one I will leave it for any other devices that I want to connect to this thing. Next. This little Bluetooth module. Let me try and focus on it. You can see its name here. It's YMX868BT. Let me try and give you even a better close-up. No chance in that. Okay, so that is the name of the module. This thing is obviously Bluetooth. And Bluetooth does not like to pass through metal, and everything in here is metal. Underneath, the back side, the top side is metal, only plastic in the front. So the antenna of the Bluetooth module needs to be somewhere in the front of this thing. Obviously I'm not going to stick it in here or something like that, but I found a way somewhere around here. I can actually install it like this, and the antenna will be directly behind plastic, so should work without issues. Another thing, this needs 5 volts. Normally this thing is even able to drive directly speakers. I think it's 3 watts per speaker or something like that, not much. Anyway, I'm not going to use the speaker output, I'm going to use the line level or the out, or whatever you want to call it. But I'm not sure if I have any outputs for 5 volts on this particular transformer. If I have something similar, or 6-7 volts or 4 volts or whatever, I'm going to use it, but I don't think I have. So what I need to do, this is an old phone charger. It doesn't have a plug anymore, but from what I remember, it's actually working. I'm going to open it, cut this part right here off, connect directly inside of it with wires, and use this cable, route it nicely through here where I need it in the front, And I think I have enough room in here behind this transformer for it if I cut this part. So I will even put a power source for this module through this in here. And obviously that will be connected in such a way that it only works when you flip the switch, not always when it's plugged in. And yeah, that's about what I'm dealing with at the moment. And hopefully all goes well and we should be able to get everything working. The switch for this thing, which is power on, will be always left in the on position. I'm not going to touch it. So every single time you start this this thing, the Bluetooth will start. If you don't play anything through it, you can simply go to zero, it's muted, and nothing happens. We don't care about it. And yeah, that should be about it. It doesn't have buttons for volume or for pairing or stuff like that. It just has 5-volt input, headphone level, or what you want to call it, audio output speakers. And I think here you actually have a charging port. It knows to charge a lithium battery. But I'm not going to use that part of it. I'm directly powering it, not through the USB. And yeah, let's get to it. And something else that I want to mention, if you ever need, I don't know, capacitors, transistors, resistors, diode bridges, modules, and transformers, and any connectors, whatever, any kind of electronics components, and even modules for the developers, go to utsource.net. They have a ton of stuff there and really good prices. I'm doing the ground wire first. As far as I know, this thing should be crimped and not soldered. So I did my best to open this thing up. In this area where the wires were held, it's impossible to open it up. It's too thick and too strong. But I opened up at least the end. This, from what it was used before, has a copper cover on it. I'm going to leave it there because it makes it a bit stronger. And I'm going to crimp it and then also solder it. So yeah, I think that's the best. But yeah, it's really important to have good ground. Yeah, might not look that nice, but it is fully soldered and also crimped, so, and it's quite stable. Happy with it. I can clean it, but that doesn't really matter that much. This area needs to be clean so it doesn't corrode, of course. And now that the ground is done, I need to move this connector to these things, so I will take out the pins, solder it, and then plug in the pins back. So let's do that in high speed. And we are done. Connected, ready to go in. And just wanted to add, if you have one of these things, put some heat shrink on it. Because with the standard clamp, it will do stuff like this on the wire. On the ground, I do not care at all. But on these ones, I didn't want anything, so I put this on it and it will remain on it. So let's plug it in and at least try and power this thing on, because I bought it a few years ago, actually, or 1 year ago, 2 years, anyway, and never powered it on, at least, because I didn't have the proper plug. So I hope it's at least working. Clean the cable, plugged it in, and let's see, do we release the black smoke or not? And we don't. So we are good. At least it's powering on. If it's working, remains to be seen. I put just a little bit of insulation tape right here on the edge where the wires are quite close to it, because you know that edges tend to be quite sharp, and yeah, this thing isn't moving in that area, but better safe than sorry. So I covered the edge. Okay, so there's a problem with this particular charger. It seems to be giving 8.3 volts. I thought it's just my multimeter reading wrong while this is without a load on it. But I think I burned the battery part of this thing. But luckily it's still working on USB. So I'm going to open this thing up and see if there's anything that I can fix. If not, I need another one to do this. But yeah, luckily everything should be working, hopefully. But this part I cannot use it anymore, the battery. not that bad, but yeah, anyway. I think I partially figured out what was happening. In here, when you connect a lithium battery, this thing never reaches 5 volts. So I don't think it's meant to get 5 volts through this thing. 5 volts I think it can only get through here, and this is trying to power with this, but I don't think it gives enough current even for only Bluetooth, even if I don't use speakers on it, because this is only 350 milliamps, extremely weak. I hope it's enough. It doesn't seem to be probably enough, and probably I gave it too much voltage through this, so I burnt that part. Doesn't really matter. This thing doesn't seem to be anything wrong with it, so either the voltage regulation is gone, but physically it all looks good inside, or yeah, doesn't give enough current to the proper port, and it was too high voltage on the wrong port. Let's search another one. Take two. 650 milliamp. Oh, actually, no, my bad. This is the wrong one. 0.5 amps. Not much bigger than the other one. But this one is actually damaged. So if I use this one, it's better in the end for me. Yeah, let me see if this is enough. I don't know. Okay, so it seems to be powering on with this particular charger. Hope you can see the red LED and the blue one blinking. So this seems to be good. So I think the other one is just Kansky. And I blew up this port with it. Anyway, hope that doesn't actually affect anything else. And yeah, at this point I do have a charger, I can power this thing on, and I want to start making connections from this particular port, which is sound out, to that one right there. Let me try and focus on it, that one. And from this one to this thingy. Because I want to be able to connect speakers and test everything before I route the wires and whatnot. So let's get to it. And yeah, I just want to tell you it will be hard to watch for some, because I'm not going to do this the nice way. I will rip a part of this green connector right here to attach the wires to the back of it, because otherwise I would need to take this whole board out, and I don't want to do that. And again, with this connector right here, I will rip the top of it. I don't need it anymore. I will block it from the other side, so nobody will ever try, although I will be using this, will ever try to plug anything in that one, because that would actually conflict with the Bluetooth, so that's better to block it. And yeah, I don't know if I told you, I cannot get 220 volts I thought this is a 220 volts input for this transformer. It's not. I think it's working at maybe a lower voltage, higher frequency. I'm not sure, or higher voltage, lower. No, actually, no, for sure, higher frequency. Anyway, and the output, again, it's not. My multimeter is unable to recognize anything, so I cannot touch anything in here, useless to me. I need to piggyback somehow from this area, from this fuse, so my charger will actually be fused also. It will be beyond the fuse, and yeah, it's not going to be nice, but I will make it as safe as humanly possible. So let's get to it. I'm sorry, but I need to do this off camera because I'm going to put my hands all over this thing in front of you, so you will not be able to see anything. So sorry about that. And it's working. I have a speaker connected just for testing. I have this thing powered on just for testing, and I connected it to let me cut off the power to everything. That's not nice. There is a ground right down there, and there is something noted or marked with R. That is right channel. Here you can see we have right and left channels. Here only right channel. And when I connect it there, it plays beautifully. So everything is working perfectly. I didn't kill this thing. I can use it. Now let's start wiring stuff in the proper way. Doing another quick test. Everything is powered on, and I have connected stereo to a single input, stereo to mono. I will explain in a moment exactly how you do that. Everything is working. Finally, all is good. Okay, so first thing, as you can see, I have a hole in there where right channel should have been. It broke. It simply broke when I tried to solder on it. Here it is. It fell through. Nothing that I could do. But luckily, I realized that actually TS was directly connected to air, and I still had TS. So instead of air, I soldered to TS. And I soldered, I made a voltage divider, basically. Two resistors in series, and the middle point, it's soldered to the input signal to this amp. And the signal that it's coming from this thing, it's on the outside wires. The middle wire is ground. So the middle wire goes to ground, and the outside wires, left and right channel, go to one of these resistors. And that is how you mix stereo. It's not perfect. In some weird situations, you might hear something a bit odd. If you want, you can simply directly solder right channel to the input on a mono amp, or the left channel to the input of a mono amp. But for me, this is the best option, because you get sounds that are in both channels. If not, you would only get what is on right channel or what is on left channel. So yeah, this is the way to do it. The values of these things can be from 1 kilo ohm. They need to be identical, both of them. So from 1 kilo ohm to about 10 kilo ohm. I had 1.5, put them in series. Middle point again in the input of the amp, and the ends on the output of this thing, left and right channel. And ground goes to ground, obviously. And yeah, that's about how you mix stereo to put it into a mono amp. It's not the perfect way. It can be done with dedicated circuitry. For me, good enough. So let's continue with this thing. I was lucky, and the wires are exactly as long as I need them. And I will put some hot glue all over this thing, because I don't want the wires moving during years of use and breaking. They are quite thin. Yes, you could use a wire with grounding on the outside. Probably it would be better, but I'm using the ones that they supplied. I think it's good enough. It's not such a long way around here. Anyway, so let's let this thing heat up and fill that area right there. And it's done. Yes, a lot of hot glue. Don't care. I don't want it to be nice. I want the wires to be impossible to break. And my baby in the background. Resistors again impossible to break. That hole is plugged, so it's impossible to try and put anything in to short circuit it. Perfect. So let's continue. Okay, so this is the second day. Everything is working as planned. And next, I want to install this thing right here. And I'm thinking this is its normal position. Let me try and focus a bit on that area. But I'm going to put it upside down because it has the leads on the lower side. And if I put it upside down, I can have them somehow under the ground. So as low as possible, it doesn't interfere with anything in here, that being the charger that I will need to put in there. So what I need to do now, drill four holes for this thing in here, in this area, remove this label, of course, and hope for the best. Ta-da! And now what I need to do is solder wire from here, put it through this hole right here, down there, solder it onto the back of this and another one, actually no, from ground to black and from this one from to red. And yeah, that should be quite nice. No shorts, no nothing. Hopefully. And again, yeah, baby in the background. And again, I did a test just to make sure that I don't use hot glue in that area and it's not working. And it's working perfectly. Everything is good up until now. So, yeah, hot glue on those wires so they never move. And everything is covered. Too much, obviously, but I don't care. And yes, my hands are shaking really bad. I have a medical situation at the moment, so hopefully in a few weeks I will be okay again. And yeah, those wires are not moving anywhere. And I also covered here in the back because 100 volts. And when I was working on this, I had the chance to put my fingers onto these things. 100 volts, I don't want that. And I'm not using absolutely anything in here. I don't have a connector for that, so I don't care. This is what I need, and it's there and working. So at this point, we are making good progress. What I need to do next is put that charger in here and that thing in there, but that will be done tomorrow for you next, but for me, it will be another day. Next thing that I want to do is see how I can hack this thing off. To fit it in that area somehow. Hopefully it works. So let's get to it in high speed. Okay, so this will fit, but there is no way to get it in there unless I remove the transformer for a bit. Anyway, I try it locks into something, so it's a perfect and really tight fit. Once it's in there, it cannot get out or move around. But yeah, at this point, I will use Kapton tape all around it to make sure this hole is closed. And the 220 volt wire will go through the side in here, not on this side. This will be flat and will have double-sided tape, so I can stick it in here from the other side. And yeah, seems it's luckily perfect. And the wires are soldered. Everything is good. Now I just need to make a hole in this case, in this area somewhere. And as you can see, it's done. This is the 220 volt wire. This is the 5 volt. Need to wrap this thing a little bit up and stick it in there. And it's done, and it's a millimeter fit. It's exactly spot on. That thing will never move from there. And this will not get extremely hot, because I realized, I think this is the output transformer, because I have a line on the board that shows me high voltage up until here, sorry, about here somewhere. So this is the high voltage area. This is for the outputs. So this is not getting extremely hot. This is doing all the work. This is getting a bit hot, but it's far away from that. Then this thing, for sure, at 500 milliamp hours, it's not going to get that hot. So, yeah, I had to trim a little bit of the hot glue that I put underneath. I put a bit too much for the connector, but now it's spot on. So, we will continue tomorrow. For you, next. Okay, so now that this thing is properly in here, and let me show you, you can see the double-sided tape right there in the middle. If my phone would actually focus on it. So this is squeezed in there perfectly. It's never going to move anywhere. And yeah, 220 volts cable. And the only place that I can take 220 volts from this thing after the fuse, sadly, without taking the motherboard or the board out, is right there. So the one of the wires will be going from this blue one to the blue one from here, and the phase is actually going through the board, through the switch, and comes out in here and then through this. So I will take it from this end, so it's after the fuse. Then that should be perfect. And this little wire, obviously, I will cut to length to reach this area here where we'll be putting the adapter. And yeah, everything else working as intended. Just want to show you the perfect configuration that this thing has for me to solder right down there and then get the wire through that hole, that cutout, and then through this cutout. So my wire will be going right next to the fuse and will affect it with absolutely nothing, which is perfect. And in here, obviously, I'm going to simply wire solder to the wire in here. Yeah, the new wire that I solder will not be crimped, because it's already crimped onto this thing. But I think I'm going to put some hot glue all around the top of this connector, just to make sure nothing can ever move. So that should be good. one final power on test to make sure everything is working, and it is. Now I will use hot glue on that thing, a little bit on this wire here to make sure it doesn't break, and then in that area a lot of it. And it's done. And the antenna is near the plastic on the front, so should be good to go. Hot's not in here from that connector, hot's not in there a lot. This is going nowhere. And I even have access to the switch if I ever want to shut this Bluetooth model off. Obviously I need to take the cover out, but not a problem. Hot's not in here. As you can see, fuse is in place and doing exactly what it should be doing. These wires cannot get cut. I put some tape, even more now that I have a second wire. This is in place, not moving anywhere. And yeah, let's close this thing up and see if everything is working as intended. Ta-da! Cleaned it up a little bit and it's looking really, really nice. And working really, really nice. So let me tell you about it. Simply power it on. And that module, the Bluetooth right in here, which has awesome signal because it's behind plastic, starts to work. And I'm not sure if I can show you, but I'm obviously going to try. Maybe you can see a bit of flickering blue light right in there. That means that by default, when you power it on and there is no Bluetooth device connected to it, it enters pairing mode. At this point, you simply go to your Bluetooth settings, turn the Bluetooth on, and voila. It directly connected it to this thing because they were paired. For you, just to show you how to pair it, of course, not change the name. This will end your connection. Disconnect. Yep, disconnect. So at this point, I think I can unpair it somehow. Unpair. Okay. You can see it here. It's a simple Bluetooth. It shows up as headphones. And it's pairing. To pair, blah, blah, blah. Allow access to your contacts because it thinks it's a headset, whatever. Pair. Beeped. And they are paired. Music starts playing by itself. So it's extremely simple to use this device. And now that I have the Bluetooth on in my phone and they are paired, power it off. And when I power on directly this thing, beep, and music starts playing, which is perfect for me. And this amp is fully working. So I have on channel 2 the Bluetooth module, which I can clearly shut off. It's still working in the background, but I don't have any volume from it. Input 1 is the microphone, and it even has on the back of it an XLR input with phantom power if required. And input 3, it accepts standard RCA connectors from what I remembered. It's on the back. So this thing is fully working with Bluetooth capability. And as for the quality of this Bluetooth module, it's awesome. So I tested, I think it's 3 days later from when I filmed the rest of the video. I tested a lot of music via Bluetooth and via that RCA input in the back. I can hear zero difference. So this thing is actually quite good in quality. And it's quite simple to use. So, and nothing is heating up. Zero, zero, zero problems. So if you have an amp and you want to add Bluetooth capability to it, even if it's a mono amp like this one that I'm going to use to test various speakers from now on my channel, you can add Bluetooth capability. Quite simple, quite effective and with really, really good quality. So yeah, and if you want to pair another device to this thing, simply shut off the Bluetooth on the already paired device and it will enter pairing mode by itself. So as long as it has nothing connected to it via Bluetooth, it's always in pairing mode. You don't need to push any buttons. You don't need to touch it. It's there. It's doing its thing. Really nice touch from whoever designed this. So yeah, let me just play a few songs for you to see how this thing actually works. Just wanted to add, this thing with the Bluetooth module sounds really good in mono, obviously stereo mixed into mono with a crappy speaker that I built 15 years ago, who knows. So with nice decent speakers, this Bluetooth module is actually quite good, and with a decent amp. Obviously this is not especially made as a high quality device for music. This is a PA amp, but still does the job for what I need. So yeah, that's about it. Everything working as intended. On the back, nice speaker connections. Let me try actually and show them to you. Everything sealed in here so I cannot get electrocuted. Here, inputs. This is on auxiliary and it's blocked. I cannot plug in anything in there. And microphone here. So fully working cable changed with EU plug now. That's about it. Hope this video helps you. I'm planning on doing things like this, adding Bluetooth to all my amps at this point. Now seeing that it's quite simple and it actually works quite okay. This particular Bluetooth model that I showed you at the beginning of the video, exact model, is quite nice, quite good. Yeah, that's about it. Thank you again for watching. Hopefully this video helps you, in which case maybe give it a like, check out my other videos, and as always, see you in the next one. Bye.